speak about intravenous fluid therapy and cannula care. Presented by Samar Subhi, Assistant Lecturer in Pediatric Department, Faculty of Nursing, Cairo University. Outlines, definition, purposes, site chosen for intravenous cannulation, common infusion fluids, common types of cannula, sites for insertion of peripheral IV cannula, common administration sites, and purposes of cannula care. Definition of intravenous fluid therapy. Intravenous fluid therapy refers to the infusion of fluids directly into the venous system. This may be accomplished through the use of needle or by the venous cut down, figure 1, and insertion of a small cannula, figure 2, directly into the vein. Figure 1 and 2 will show it in the next slide. Figure 1, venous cut down, and figure 2 represent insertion of a small cannula. Purposes of intravenous fluid therapy. Purposes of intravenous fluid therapy. First, to restore and maintain the child fluid and electrolyte balance and the body homeostasis when his oral intake is inadequate to serve this purpose. Second, replace severe fluid loss in emergency situations such as in severe burn, severe hemorrhage, and severe dehydration, such as in figure 3, we'll show it in the next slide. Third, administer medication when the other routes are not appropriate, such as in this figure. In this figure, we'll show you severe burns and severe hemorrhage and dehydration in children. This is severe burn, and this is severe hemorrhage, and this is the dehydration sign and symptoms in pediatric. Site for intravenous cannulation. Sites selection in pediatric patient is determined by, first, the rate and type of fluid to be infused, second, the availability of veins, third, the developmental level of the child, such as placement of IV line into the foot of toddler is often a poor choice. Scalp veins are often the most accessible in infants, and the scalp veins have no valves and may be infused in either direction. In older children, any accessible vein may be used. Second, when selecting an IV site, the nurse should start with veins of the hand or forearm and work from distal to proximal, because if the IV infiltrates vessels proximal to the IV site can be used, such as in figure 4. We'll begin from arm for arm. This is from distal to proximal. Common infusion fluids that can be used in pediatric patients. First of all is Neumint solution. It is a partial nutrition supplies for infant from the first day to the 30 days. Second is Bediamine, partial nutrition supplies for infant from 1 month to 3 years. The third is normal saline. The fourth is plasma and plasma expanders, blood and its blood products, parenteral nutrition solutions vary depending on the other disorder present and the child age. Next, dextrose 5%, and the last is ringer lactate. Common types of cannula that can be used in a pediatric patient. Types of cannula. Various types of cannula are available and prepared commercially in sterile bags. Cannula may have an inner needle surrounded by plastic cannula, or the cannula takes as the butterfly shape, as we're showing in these figures. Here is the color of the cannula and the gauge size and the recommended uses in this. Size for insertion of preferred IV cannula. There is a lot of size to insertion the cannula, such as in this figure. In this figure, I will show you where is the cannula can be insertion in the hand, forearm, leg, and the skull vein in the head. In this figure, I will show you the veins can be used to insert the cannula in the head and the neck. Common administration sets that can be used in a pediatric patient. Barrett or IV set, normal or usual IV set. The drop factor for macro drop infusion set is 15 drop per minute. Salicylate micro drip, usually mainly used when the amount of fluid to be given is 100 milli or below. The drop factor for micro drip infusion or salicylate is 60 drop per minute. Diaflow. Next, syringe pump, which mainly used when a specialized medication need to be given slowly, such as dopamine and dobutrix. The infusion pumps are often used in a pediatric to provide a constant or a slow and controlled rate of infusion. Next, if the blood is infused, used with the filter infusion set is 10 drop per minute. Common infusion flow rates. Common infusion flow rate. In order to maintain a flow of infusion at the prescribed rate, the number of drops per minute required for each particular infusion has to be accurately calculated. The number of drops per milli or for any set is known as a drop factor. Formula used for a calculation of infusion flow rate, which is total volume of infusion fluid multiply of drop factor divided to total time of infusion in a minute. We can take an example. Ahmed is 6 months old. Infant has a severe diarrhea and vomiting, admitted to pediatric hospital in a dehydration unit. The physician prescribed to him IV infusion as follows: 50 cc normal saline, 30 cc glucose 5%, and 20 cc ringer lactate. And this solution should take in 8 hours by using micro drip infusion sets, which is salicylate. Please calculate the flow rate of infusion for this child. Okay, we'll begin to answer this question. The calculation. First of all, we will write the formula: total volume of infusion fluid multiplied by drop factor divided into total time in a minute. Then we will go to the example. The example said Ahmed will take 50 normal saline, 30 glucose 5%, and 20 ringer lactate, which is 100 cc. Then multiply of drop factor. Drop factor for micro drip or salicylate, each which is 60. And then Ahmed will take it for 8 hours. We will write 8, then multiply of total time in a minute, so we write 60. The answer is 12 drop per minute. will do a cannula care for a lot of purposes, such as the first purpose of for cannula care is to monitor and assess the IV cannula site and the surrounding area at least hourly or more frequently as required and document same. Second, apply measures to minimize and or to prevent IV related complication. Then, implement aseptic technique prior to manipulation of IV device and IV system to reduce association risk of infection to the complication of cannula can be divided into local complication and systemic complication. Local complication such as infiltration, extravasation, thrombosis, cellulitis, and phlebitis. Systemic complication such as embolism, hematoma, systemic infection, speed shock, circulatory overload, and allergic reaction. Summary. To summarize what we say, we speak about IV survey and cannula care. We speak about these items or these outlines, definition, purpose, site of cannulation, different type of infusion fluids and IVC, and how to calculate flow rate for infusion. I want you to remember that drop factor for usual IV set is 15, and serocet is 60, and the blood set is 10. It is important to provide cannula care to prevent complication and infection. And thank you. Thank you for now. We'll begin to prepare the equipment. So the required equipment is IV solution, the kind of solution as the doctor prescribed, tray, IV administration, appropriate size of cannula, syringe, 5 or 10 milli, normal saline, cotton sponge with alcohol and dry sponge, surgical adhesive tape, kidney basin, label, padded arm board, restraining device, if necessary, doctor. The required equipment, IV solution, as prescribed, tray, IV administration set according to the medication we've given, appropriate size of cannula, based on pediatric, it will be 20 or 24, syringe, 5 or 10 milli, normal saline, cotton sponge with alcohol, and others for dry and dry cotton, kidney basin, surgical adhesive tape, label, padded arm, board, restraining device if necessary, Dr. A, order sheet. Procedure, first we begin to assess, check the infusion fluid as prescribed by the doctor. Check the following details in the prescribed medication sheet: child name, room and the bed number, the date of prescription, the type of prescribed fluid, the amount of prescribed fluid, container labeled for IV therapy, expiry date of the IV fluid, time of prescribing the IV therapy in the sheet, time of taking the IV therapy infusion, signature of the mechanical of medical practitioner, check the fluid for cloudiness, sedimation, and discoloration, establish and cooperation of the child, and wash your hands with soap and under running water, prepare all needed equipment, set up the intravenous infusion in the area not visible to the child, inspect the solution for any abnormalities and the priority of infusion. Write down the date on the label of the medication, room number, child name, component, start from dripping per amount on the label, and then put it on the bottle. Remove a protective cap from the spike of the infusion and insert through the outlet hole of the bottle stopper.
squeeze the chamber and fill the chamber of 1/3 to the half solution. This volume prevents bubbles air for entering the tube. Remove a protective covering from the needle adapter and opening the clamp, and then run the solution through tubing, allowing some fluid to view needle adapter, and close the clamp. Don't touch the needle adapter at any place. Explain to the child and the mother why the infusion is needed. Select appropriate vein for puncture site. Restrain the child by using cord restraint. Tie the tourniquet above the vein when needed it be inserted. Clean the area with cotton alcohol. Insert the needle and check for blood return. Remove the tourniquet. Fixation with non-adhesive tape. The cannula with non-irritant adhesive tape. Connect the needle to infusion and set and fit. Connect needle to infusion and set and fit the tube. Connect the needle to infusion, set and fit the tube. Start to drop and set the IV flow rate according to the doctor order. Dispose the equipment properly. Follow up phase. Check the child at least hourly for. Note the color of the skin at the needle point. Check the location of IV needed, check the, for the swelling of the skin at the needle point, if in the hand or foot, compare with the opposite side. Feel the area around the IV set for any leakage. Verify the IV access if is patent and without any complication, such as extravasation, tenderness, and redness. Check for blood return into the tubing. When the flow of the fluid is stopped, weigh the child at regular interval using the same scale each time. maintain accurate recording of intake and output every 8 hours. Record essential for information, reading on bottle, on a bottle or reservoir, amount of fluid absorbed in the hour, total amount of fluid infused compared with the total amount of fluid intended to be infused, a rate of flow, apparent condition of the child. Stop. IV as necessary as follows. Gather the equipment, syringe with normal saline and several alcohol wipes, clamp the solution, clamp of the solution, and disconnect it. Gather the equipment, syringe with 1 to 3 ml of normal saline and several alcohol wipes, clamp of solution, aspirate first. Disconnect the IV tubing as a needle insertion type and keep it sterile. Connect the syringe to the tubing at the needle insertion site. Slowly inject the normal saline. Disconnect the syringe and reconnect the IV tubing. To the needle insertion site, unclamp and regulate the follow up of the solution rate. Check frequently to make certain that the IV is functioning properly.